used to be brawny trucks were the specialty of American brands. This is no cute ute. Everything about Toyota's 4Runner firmly states it's a full-on truck. The fifth generation is taller, longer, wider, and more powerful. Seems like the designers were inspired by Picasso's cubic phase. Over the years, many SUV owners have come to realize they don't need the extreme capability of a body-on-frame truck chassis like 4Runners here. In fact, many manufacturers are switching over to car-based crossover designs because they get better fuel economy. The trick to remember, if you've got a job to do, choose the right tool. Tackling tough terrain or towing up to 5,000 pounds of toys doesn't work so well with a Highlander or RAV4. 4Runner makes short work of extreme conditions that are much more severe than this. Available with a 157-horse four-cylinder, I'm driving the 4-liter V6 with 270 horsepower and 278 pound-feet of torque. The new 4Runner's fuel economy improves slightly to 17 city, 22 highway when equipped with four-wheel drive. This engine gets a 5-speed transmission. This big rig can move. A 0 to 60 time of just over 7 seconds matches some sporty cars. On regular roads, it's quiet, smooth, and comfortable, but you won't forget it's a truck. Ride quality is a bit bouncy on choppy pavement, and its tall ride height emphasizes body roll. 4Runner's cargo hold has more features than some cars I've tested. These can take care of any power need. Storage is helpful, so are tie downs. All in long stuff? Well, there you go. 4Runner can be had with a third row. An optional sliding floor makes loading stuff to the back a little easier. Good for tailgaters, too. Lots of intrusions make the space look smaller. It's why I only brought 12 packs of TP out. I should have snagged 14. The interior is a square deal. Everything about it looks equipped by REI. Controls are large and easy to grab. Heated leather chairs are firm and comfortable. Hopefully, buyers like the color orange. Lots of silver-painted plastic, and across the board, it's of the hard kind. Phones and iPods are supported. Climate control is manual on SR5s, and so are the lights. 4Runner is a truck, so it's a bit of a hike once inside. Three adults should be okay back here. Order the sunroof, and there's quite a scallop to the roof line. There are places for stuff back here, but no power port for charging electronics. Seats don't slide fore and aft, but passengers can relax. Starting at $28,300 for a four-cylinder version, this SR5 stickers for $36,000. In short, the big brawny 4Runner takes the old-school SUV approach. For those squaring off with tough tasks, Toyota's new 4Runner doesn't back down. Interesting that Toyota 4Runner and Nissan Pathfinder have kept body-on-frame truck designs where the domestic brands have gone towards unibody. Common belief is that unibody simply means lightweight soft rotors like Equinox or Flex. Tell that to Land Rover. Also, the excellent new Jeep Grand Cherokee, Dodge Durango, and Ford Explorer proves that to be just plain wrong. If you're spending this kind of coin on a sport ute, they should all be on your test drive list. I'm Tom Voelk.